afternoon, all. Hello, countdowners out there, and hello, Carol. New week.
Hello, Dezo. Hello. Yes, it's a very special day today. Did you know that I'm half Welsh?
I mean,
we're learning about each other. I'm half Welsh, half Dutch.
Dutch?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, half Welsh, half Dutch. It's a very special day because the goddess of Wales, Dame Shirley Bassey.
Yeah.
Do you know she looks so fantastic in all of those adverts at the moment? She's actually 70 years old today, so happy birthday, Dame
70.
Shirley.
Happy birthday. I'm allowed to call her Shirl.
You are, aren't you?
I'm the only one that's allowed to call her Shirl.
Really? You must have met her a few times, actually.
Well, actually, I better be careful what I say here. She might be watching. I know Shirl Evans. I actually took her out on a date in this very town, Leeds. I was appearing at the Halifax Palace quite a few years back. It would be wonderful if Shirley was watching. She was at the Grand at Leeds. Well, she would be at the Grand.
Well, you know. Yes, absolutely.
And I sort of rang her up. I thought she was very cute. I was free and unattached in those days, so I rang her up. And she said, oh, I'd love to. And so I took her out. I took her out on the lake. I rode on the lake.
Oh, how romantic.
Then we went for a candlelit dinner.
Yeah.
Then I took her. And she. This happened, by the way, and when I did the audience with, she asked if I remembered that evening.
Oh, no.
She was in the audience, and she's telling everybody, which something which was sort of fairly private, and she said, you remember then you took me home to my hotel?
Yeah.
And you went to my room, and then you kissed me on the cheek, and you left. And I said, in the audience, I said, what did you think? She said, I thought you were gay.
She is wonderful. So happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Shirl. Well, she's in Monte Carlo or something, but we'll send her the tape. Right, kind of another big day here as well because we've got a new champion. A new champion currently here with us. John, you've overturned all the form and you beat Anita Freeland. She was, if she'd won, she would have then been an octo champ.
Yeah.
So, John, congratulations to you. And you've got a young guy here who's he's after you. He's a new boy like me, but by the way, have you noticed we've all coordinated in brown here?
Absolutely.
Very smart. I was going to ask, can you walk in that skirt?
No, though? I can't walk. I can only stand in this skirt,
yes.
By the way.
I'd love to see you going up and down those steps. Right, this is young Bradley Cates. He's 11 years old, 11, and his mum, Caroline, is in the audience somewhere. Well, she'll give us a wave later on. And you attend Birkdale High School. That's in Southport, isn't it, Bradley?
Yep.
Yeah. And he loves to play Scrabble and do word searches and hopes to be an accountant one day.
Yep.
I've heard you could be more than an accountant. You could be the Chancellor one day. You never know. Anyway, wish them both luck, will you?
Well, with us all of this week is a man who's absolutely no stranger to Dictionary Corner because he first appeared on Countdown in 1990, 17 years ago, when Susie Dent was still learning her ABC. So sitting alongside the lovely Susie, please give a very warm Countdown welcome to actor and friend of the programme, the velvet-voiced Viceroy himself, Mr. Martin Jarvis.
Oh. Well, thank you, Carol. Very nice of you. I don't know about velvet voice, but it's great to be here. It's great to see you, Des. Good luck to John and Bradley. And I've never met Shirl, I have to say. Never met Shirl, but I am an eighth Welsh. My grandma was Welsh. Does that make me an eighth Welsh?
Can you do a Welsh accent?
Oh, well, I've done them in my time.
Ah, very good.
No, or you could say, no, I bloody well can't, you know. Anyway, it's great also to see my dear old friend Susie, my dear young friend Susie, and we're going to have some fun.
So it's on with the game, and good luck to our young challenger here. Our John is our champion, so you're going to start first with some letters, please.
OK, Carol. Consonant, please.
Thank you, John. R.
And another one?
N.
And a vowel?
And E.
And another consonant?
H.
A vowel?
A.
And consonant?
S.
Another consonant?
K.
And a consonant.
Consonant, yes. T.
And a vowel.
Yeah, you have to have the third vowel,
yeah.
Don't you? And that's O.
And here's that clock.
Thank you.
So, John, how'd you go there?
Try an eight.
Try an eight. And Bradley?
Seven.
Seven. We better have your seven first, Bradley.
Honkers.
Honkers. Not conkers, honkers. Is honkers there? I think it is. We'll try yours, John, while we're looking.
Thankers.
It's the first thing I looked at, John, and it's not there. Oh, right. You can't be a thanker in the dictionary, unfortunately.
You can't be a thanker?
No.
What about honkers here?
Honker, I'm sure will be fine. A personal thing that honks.
Honk.
Fantastic.
Very good.
Well, there's young Bradley off to a flying start with 7 points there. You're nuts over to champ, so it's looking good so far.
Well, we can't do any better than that, but we can do hornets. If anyone at home has got hornets, that's pretty good. And you couldn't have thankers, but you can have hankers.
Hankers?
Hankers. He hankers after getting an eight-letter word.
Yes.
and harkens.
Yep, yes? Just yes. The sevens.
Very
the
seven, good. Yeah. Very good. OK, young Bradley, it's your turn now to pick out some letters.
Consonant, please, Carol.
Hello, Bradley. It's nice to see you. Welcome to Countdown. D.
A vowel.
E.
Another vowel.
O.
Consonant.
L.
And another consonant.
B.
A vowel, please.
A.
A consonant, please.
D.
And a vowel.
E.
And the final consonant.
And a consonant, thank you. S.
And here's one more, is that clock? So, Bradley, what do you do with that?
Six.
Six, and John?
Six as well.
Six. Let's have yours first, Bradley.
Bleeds.
John?
Blades.
Bleeds and blades, yeah. What have you got there? Did we beat that?
Just. It was a really nasty selection, actually, wasn't
it's
it?
Very tricky. Oliver Twist, is there a beadle? And therefore, could you have a beadle? Could you have plural of beadle?
Beadles, brilliant. The policeman. Excellent.
Sort of police cop. Type of a person, yeah. Dickens. Now, that's seven, isn't it?
Very good.
I managed least. That's the least I can
do.
And saddle, yeah, you said.
Saddle's another six, yeah.
Another six, but...
Another six. Well, the scores are interesting. Our champion's got six and the challenger got 13. So, Bradley, you're doing very nicely. And, John, it's your turn once again to give us some more letters.
OK, consonant, please.
Thanks, John. N.
Another one.
T.
And a vowel.
U.
A consonant.
X.
Yeah. Vowel, please.
E.
A consonant.
P.
Another consonant.
R.
A consonant.
C.
And a vowel.
And a vowel, thank you. A.
Once more, the clock. In the middle. What about that, John?
Six.
Six, then, Bradley?
Safe six.
Safe six?
Yep.
Like that. That's a safe six. Let's hear the safe six.
Carpet.
Carpet.
Oh, great.
Good boy. Pretty safe. And you, John?
Punter.
Punter?
Yeah.
Yes. Bradley, what is your risky seven?
I think of carpent, like carpenter.
Ah, no, not there. I'm glad you left that one, Bradley.
But you left that one, you'd pick the right one to go with.
So there is a seven. Capture.
Capture.
Yes.
Capture. And there's a very nice three, which I know Des... I always associate this three-letter word with Des.
Yeah.
T-U-X, tux. You're tux. Always wearing a tux. Well, and all the awards that you accept or give
thank
away.
Thank God I haven't had any tux. That's the important thing. You know, champion 12 and our challenger 19, and this time it's Bradley's choice of letters.
A consonant, please, Carol.
H.
And a vowel...
O.
Consonant.
D.
And the vowel.
E.
And a consonant?
N.
And a vowel?
I.
Consonant?
S.
And another?
G.
And another consonant, please,
Another consonant, Bradley. That's R.
And here's another clock. So, John.
Seven.
Seven. And Bradley?
Six.
Six. Better have the six first, Bradley.
China.
John?
Horsing.
Horsing?
Horsing.
How do you spell that?
That'll be fine. To horse about, to horse around. It should be fine. And it is. Yep, there is a verb.
Is that like clowning around? Is
exactly. Stop horsing about.
When you're horsing around. Did you do any better over there?
Well, we think we've got a seven ignored.
Yes.
When I say we, it's mostly her work, not mine. Yes. You know. And hinders.
Hinders is another seven.
Hinders.
Yeah.
Well, the scores are getting interesting now. Champion 19, challenger 19. So we've got a real game on here. And now we go to numbers, and it's you, John.
OK, one big and the rest small, please.
One big and five small. OK, let's see, boys. 2 and 4, 10 and 3. 1 and 100. And remember, John, Bradley wants to be an accountant, OK? So our target is 975.
975. Here's the clock. So, John, what do you make of that?
Yep, 975.
975, Bradley?
975.
No, both got 975. Let's see, how do you do that, John?
OK, 10 times 100.
10 multiplied by 100, obviously, you're all the way up to 1,000.
4 by 3 by 2 is 24.
4 multiplied by 3 is 12, by 2 is 24.
Add the 1.
OK, and take all that away to give you 975. Yeah.
Ah. Do we have a look at Bradley's as well?
I did the 100 times 10, which is from that. I did 3 plus 2 equals 5, then 4 plus 1 equals 5, and multiply those two together equals 25, and take that from the 1,000.
He's a nippy little chappy. He can move faster than you can in that dress.
He can. I'm very old, Bradley. Could you just go a little bit slower for me? Go on. We've got 1,000.
I did 3 plus 2 equals 5,
yeah.
Then 4 plus 1 equals 5, and multiply the 2,000
together. And that's 25, and then you take it away. Yeah. Yes, well done, young
Ten
man.
10 points for both of these two. Wonderful. Wow, great fun. And a real game on here, 29-29. Martin!
Well, Bradley, I hope I'm not going to go too slow for you on this one, but I was in a certain part of London yesterday, and I wonder if... at first, you'll recognise this location. Is it a poem? Or maybe it's the beginning of a rather famous lyric. When true lovers meet in Mayfair, so the legend tells, some birds sing, winter turns to spring. Every winding street in Mayfair falls beneath the spell. I know such enchantment can be, because it happened one evening to me. That certain night... Mm-hmm. The night we met, there was magic abroad in the air. There were angels dining at the Ritz, and a nightingale sang in Berkeley Square. I may be right, I may be wrong, but I'm perfectly willing to swear that when you turned and looked at me, a nightingale sang in Berkeley Square. The moon that lingered over London town, poor puzzled moon, he wore a frown. How could he know? We two were so in love. The whole darn world seemed upside down. The streets of town were paved with stars. It was such a romantic affair. And as we kissed and said good night, everyone,
a nightingale sang in Barley Square. Carol, you were singing that. That's lovely. Pity you didn't sing that. I'd like to hear you sing. Can you sing, Mark?
No, I'm good at patter, but not singing.
I've never had the problem myself. Moving on, we're going to have a teaser here to end this part, and it's Send Edit. Send Edit, It's All Happening to Plan. Send Edit, It's All Happening to Plan. Well, here's the answer to that teaser. The clue was Send Edit. It's all happening to plan. Answer? Destined. Yeah. Destined.
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 Destined. Destined.
Yeah, it's got my name in there. I can't complain about that. Very nice. OK, we're moving on with the scores of 29 each. Very interesting game today. And Bradley, our challenger, some letters, please.
A consonant, please, Carol.
Thank you, Bradley. M.
And a vowel?
E.
And another vowel?
O.
Consonant?
S.
And another consonant?
F.
And a vowel?
I.
And a consonant?
Q.
And a vowel?
E.
And a consonant?
And, Bradley, that's T.
And here's the clock. How did you do with that one, Bradley?
Six.
Six. And John?
Just five.
Just five, but I hear that first.
Times.
Times. Yes, Bradley?
Motifs.
Motifs. That's excellent. Good boy. Any better in the corner there? Any better?
Well, Susie's got something rather clever here.
Yeah, it is just a six, but somite is there. S-O-M-I-T-E. It's quite an interesting zoological term. If you look at an earthworm, it's got lots of body segments, and they're called somites.
Oh.
Good song. Thanks, Emma.
I managed to emote a little. That's about as far as I
could. Very good.
Excellent.
Emotes is there.
Pretty good. OK, we'll move on. The scores, I'd say interesting. Champion 29. Our young challengers got 35. John, do some work here.
OK, consonant, please.
N.
And another one.
T.
And a vowel.
I.
And another vowel, please.
U.
Consonant.
S.
Another consonant.
P.
And another consonant.
F.
A vowel.
A.
And a consonant,
and
please.
A consonant. And L.
And a clock. Oh, Bradley, how did you do that?
Six.
Six, and John?
Seven.
Seven. Let's have your six, Bradley.
Plants.
Plants, right. And John?
Uplifts.
I'm sure it'll be absolutely fine, and it is. Very well done.
How do we do in the corner there, you guys?
Well, not too bad. We've got flaunts, which is for seven, and then we've got fustian, rather a nice old, almost Elizabethan, it sounds.
Oh, I like just the sound of it.
Fustian, which Susie tells me is a cloth, but I always think of some old theatrical costume. Yeah. And then what about nuptials for eight?
Oh, you can't forget your nuptials.
Can't forget
your nuptials. Go for nuptials. Nuptials is excellent. Right, that takes the scores. It gets more interesting as we move through this game. Our challenger 35, our champion 36. So, Bradley, once again, some letters from you, please.
A consonant, please, Carl.
Thanks, Bradley. R.
And the vowel?
O.
And the consonant?
S.
And the vowel?
A.
The consonant?
D.
And the vowel?
E.
Consonant?
T.
And another?
Z.
And the final consonant, please, Cal.
Thank you, darling. That's D.
Once more, here's the clock. Found that very difficult. How about you guys, John?
Seven.
Seven. And Bradley?
Seven.
Seven. Now, let's have your seven first, Bradley.
Roasted.
Roasted? Good boy. John?
Same word.
Roasted. I was roasted then. I don't think I got four that time. What about you guys?
Thanks to Susie, we've got a rather nice word. Torsade or torsade?
Yes, torsade.
Torsade, which is?
It's a decorative braid or ribbon that you can wear in your hair or on your clothes.
Which we're none of us wearing this afternoon.
No.
But can you have the word ersatz?
Excellent, you can. A poor substitute for something.
Yeah, ersatz coffee, a sort of, you know, maybe instant coffee instead of the real thing.
I've never had a cup of ersatz, but I'll take your word for it. Okie doke. Now, look at these scores. Champion 43, challenger 42. A real game on again. John, letters, please.
Consonant, please.
N.
And another one?
B.
And a vowel?
A.
And another vowel?
E.
Consonant?
S.
Another consonant?
T.
Another consonant?
R.
A vowel?
I.
And A. Another vowel, please.
Another vowel?
Yes.
Sure, yes. A vowel.
A vowel, a cow.
Okay. And A.
And here's the clock. John, what do you make of that?
Just six.
Just six. And Bradley?
Seven.
Seven. John, we'll hear yours.
Baster.
As in turkeys, yes. And Bradley?
Banters.
Banters.
Oh, that's a good one.
Well good boy. How'd the corner do?
Well, the committee put their heads together and we've come up with a nine.
We have.
You say it.
Oh, thank you. If you abstain from something, you are an abstainer, and that's there for nine.
An abstainer gets nine, so it's not one over the eight, is it? If you're drinking, you're not abstaining. Just thinking. But I think we both abstain, don't we, Carl?
Oh, always.
Yes.
Until about 6 o'clock in the evening.
And then out come the wine gums. Okay, the scores keep changing around here. Champion 43, young challenger 49. Round 10 coming up. Numbers, Bradley, please.
One large and five small, please, Carl.
One large, Bradley, and five small numbers for you. Let's see what we have this time. 9 and 1, 10 and 3, 7, and from the top row we've got 25. And a reasonable target, very nice actually, 247.
247 on the clock. Nice little smile on Bradley's face. How'd you do, Bradley?
247.
Good boy.
I think I've got 247.
You think you've got?
Yeah.
So what do we do here? We'll try your 247.
OK, 25 by 10.
Yes.
And take the three away.
It's 250. Are you sure?
Yeah, I think there's a three there.
There's a three left. Yeah, take it away, yeah.
And Bradley?
Same.
It's the same, is it?
Check his writing, Des.
Yes. Yeah. I'm sure it's right.
Is it neat?
Yeah, it's very neat.
Is it?
Yes, he's using all the paper properly. Good boy, yeah. Wonderful.
Excellent.
So they're both correct. Right, tea time teaser. Time. Glideon. Glideon. Singing to a Swiss movement. Glideon. Swinging. Singing. Get that right, Des. Singing to a Swiss movement. All you countdowners are going to have to forgive me. I sort of gave you a bit of a bum steer with that little clue there. And young Bradley in the break said, no, it's not glideon, it's glide on, yon, singing to a Swiss movement. The answer is yodeling.
Yodeling.
Thank you very much for that help.
Yeah.
Listen, this score, this is fascinating. 53, the champion, our young challenger, 59, game on. And John's going to choose some letters.
Consonant, please.
Thank you, John. N.
And another one.
R.
And vowel.
E.
And another vowel.
O.
And a consonant.
L.
And another consonant.
G.
And another consonant.
P.
And a vowel.
E.
And another vowel.
And we end this round with I.
And another clock. Do that time, John?
Six.
Six. And Bradley?
Seven.
Seven. Okay, John?
Region.
Region. Yeah, that's correct. And Bradley?
Eloping.
Eloping.
Brilliant.
I'd like to know, what do you know about eloping? Nice word, though.
He knows how to spell it.
He knows how to spell it. That's the important thing. How about the corner, though?
I'm afraid we can't do as well as you, Bradley. We haven't got, peeling and reeling, but, you know, nothing as good as eloping.
Well done. Okay, the score's very interesting. Our champion, 53. The challenge is edging away at 66. So, Bradley, can you keep this going? Some letters, please.
A consonant, please, Carl.
R.
And a vowel.
Thanks, love. That's E.
And a consonant.
M.
And a vowel.
O.
And the consonant.
Y.
And the vowel.
I.
And the consonant.
P.
And another.
C.
And another consonant, please.
And another consonant, thank you, Bradley. That is V.
And here's the clock. Bradley?
I'll try a six.
You're going to try a six, and John?
Just five.
Just five. We better hear the five first.
Crimp.
Crimp. As in hair, is it? Crimp?
Yeah.
Bradley, try your six.
Mopia.
It certainly used to be in. Bradley, I will just check. What does it mean? To be more mopey, to be more sulky, so sulkier it is there. Oh. Well done.
Brilliant.
I wouldn't have thought that word was there, Bradley.
Mopia.
Looks very strange, doesn't it?
He's more mopier than he was yesterday, sort of thing, I suppose.
You're not looking at me, are you?
Not at all, no. I'm sure you never moped, Des.
I try not to.
We think we may improve
yes.
on this. improve for 7.
I'll improve.
And,
and then... Very good.
But then, rather proud of this one. Rather a nice sort of swaggery kind of word. Viceroy.
Well done. Oh, that's brilliant.
Viceroy. Very splendid and regal. We look at the scores. It's 53 champion, 72 to our challenger. And John, some more letters, please.
A consonant, please.
S.
And another one.
R.
And a vowel.
U.
And a consonant.
D.
And a vowel.
A.
And another vowel.
I.
And a consonant.
M.
Another consonant.
T.
And a vowel, please.
And a vowel. And E.
And here's the clock. John, how we got that time?
Just 6.
6, and Bradley?
7.
7. John?
Raised.
R-A-I-S-E-D, yep. Raised. And Bradley?
Tardies.
Tardies. Well, we have tardiest very often. I don't think we're going to find tardy there as a noun, Bradley. No, we're not, I'm afraid. It has to be tardiest, which comes up a lot on the show.
Well, that's a shame, because it ought to be there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bad luck.
Any more up there?
Well, we had Mopia just now. Are you ever the mardiest card in the pack? Mardy is a bit like Mopy, isn't it?
It is. Salty.
You feel very Mardy.
The words sound, I have the feel, don't they? Yeah.
Mardiest. Mardiest is 8. And then you'll know that I didn't personally get this one. I'll leave you to Muriates.
Muriates. M-U-R-I-A-T-E-S.
Ah,
yes.
Of course.
Very good.
Champion 59, challenger 72. Bradley, some numbers.
One large, five small again, please, Carol.
OK, thank you. Oh, you're so fast when you ask for them. OK, five small numbers, one large number. Here they are. 10 and 10. 5 and 3 and 8. Those are the small numbers. And the big one is 100. And the target is 972.
972, 1 clock. Bradley?
972.
972. John?
One away.
One away. All right, let's hear you, Bradley.
100 minus 3 equals 97. Multiplied by 10 equals 170.
Yeah.
10 minus 8 equals 2.
That's the other 10, now isn't it, Bradley? Minus the 8 is the 2, and then you?
Add them on.
And you get 10 points!
That's marvellous, marvellous. And you're leaping ahead now, but we have the conundrum to go here, so fingers on the buzzers. Please reveal today's countdown conundrum. John?
Oh, no, I don't think I've got it. It's not rescinded. No.
Rest of the time to Bradley, then. Start the clock now. Bradley.
Is it re-incised?
Let's have a look. It's residence. So there you are, the score's 59, the champion, 82 for our new champion, young Bradley. And John, listen, I'm sure you're saying, oh, am I going to get ribbed when I go back and say an 11-year-old kid? But he was a very bright little 11-year-old, this one. I think he's going to go on and do... I hope you enjoyed a short stay with us for 2 days.
Excellent. I've got one show.
Yeah, you're going to get your teapot.
Oh, brilliant. Well, that's what I came for.
The collector's items, yeah. They will. I'm sure they will be. Thank you, Martin, as ever. The Viceroy.
The Viceroy.
Susie. And a lovely Carol. Happy birthday again, Cheryl. Have fun. We'll see you all tomorrow, 3:30.
Kidnapped shootings, chaos, one heck of an ER cliffhanger. Well, hang no more. The first of a brand new series of ER at 10 tonight here on 4. And it was a breathtaking win on Deal or No Deal yesterday. So what does today have in store? Find out with Noel next.